Hi everyone, so welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to analyze GMR infra from a long-term perspective. Okay? So here I'm on this website tradingview.com, and this is a daily chart of GMR infra. So first I'm going to select boring candle, the indicator which I usually use, the fourth one, boring candle Amol Joshi. So just click on that, and whenever you want to see the colors, you are just supposed to click on boring candle and it will show you red, blue and green color candles, right? Okay, now since I'm going to analyze this from a long-term perspective, so usually you should always start with a monthly time frame. The higher the time frame, the higher it will be a bit easier for you to analyze from a long-term perspective. Okay, the reason I always select boring candle is because I usually follow demand supply concept. And we also need to ensure that we are not missing out on any demand or any supply, right? So now here, if you see, let me try to draw a horizontal line over here, which was somewhere around 132. Okay, the stock made a low, or let's say I would say a bottom of somewhere around 9. Okay, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to apply a Fibonacci from this high to this low. Okay, now from this, if you see, there is this clear bottom which was formed, and this is the, now the breakout area wherein, you know, it was somewhere around June 2014, and it's been almost 6-7 years now that this stock is breaking out on a upside. Okay, so due to a very long consolidation, and also if you check this candles, this is a very wide range candle. The first candle which I'm talking about, the September month candle, is a wide range candle. If I check from a percentage perspective, there was like 32% of gain in the month of September, and now we are in the month of October, there is already 7% of rally. So it gave a closing above this, but again it is on a monthly chart. Okay, now If I say, let's say FIBO, then I'll be marking some of the levels, which is 50, 61.8, and the final one is 107. Okay. Now, I will get rid of FIBO first, so that it should not confuse you. Now, even if I apply only the demand and supply logic, if you check from the right to left, you're supposed to spot if you are able to see any of the supply. If you are able to see any of the supply. So now here, if you see, there was this red candle. There was this big red candle. There was a drop of somewhere around 30%. And then there was this three blue candle, which is boring candle. And then there was again red. It came down. It went into this zone, which was again a supply zone for me. And then from there, the stock made a very new low. But now, since this is already tested, so I'm expecting for the first time the stock is going to break this on the upside. So I'm not going to give major importance to 70 and 85 levels. So the reason I'm going to delete this from this list to avoid a confusion. So now I am left with 107 and 132, which would be a kind of double top. You can also consider this as a kind of round bottom pattern. Let's say if I try to draw a curve like this, so you can still consider it as a rounding bottom, because there is already a bottom which is already formed. There was this very long, huge consolidation, and then now the stock is breaking on the upside. Okay, this way. Now, if you just check the current price action, there was this red candle, there was this blue candle, and then big green, and again a green. So now here, if you see, again for me, this is a demand zone. This is a demand zone. Even though the month is not yet closed, for the month of October, I'm talking about. So still there's a very good green candle for the month of September. So still it will be considered as a demand zone, but a bit low importance. But right now for me, the leg out is very big. So if you see here on the left side, there are two green candles. The first was a bit small, and the second was a wide range candle. But still, it was a red, four blue and green. if you see, it went on the upside, it came down, it came in this zone. So if I just try to mark this level, so this was the demand. It came in the zone, it went deep in the zone, and then it was somewhere around 14 rupee, and then again if you see now it is somewhere around 40 rupee. Okay, so the demand was valid. So but then I'm again going to give a major importance to this level, because for me it is a very strong candle, and this is the area which I'm marking for this demand zone. So there are two options which you can do in case if you are planning to invest in GMR Infra. You can add this stock at current market price as well. You can maybe you can buy some like 25 to 50% of quantity over here, and in case of a dip, or let's say in case of a pullback, it is going to, in case if it is going to, you know, give a pullback to this region, you can go long. Okay, it is not my recommendation, but you can go long. The risk reward is always favorable. If you see from this perspective, the demand zone is at around 30 rupee and the stop loss is somewhere around 27. You can consider, let's say, a bit on the lower side. You need to give some room to the stop. Anyways, so my point is, you can again add this at current market price, maybe in a small quantity, and in case if there is a pullback, you can add this at somewhere around this level. So let me mark it as demand zone. Again, I'm repeating, for me this is a very strong demand zone. This is a very strong demand zone which ideally you should not be missing. Now I'm coming on to a we have already checked on a monthly time frame, we have already checked that now there is no supply zone on the left side, right? So now I'm going to change the time frame to, let's say, weekly chart. Okay. Now, since I'm on a weekly chart, now here if you see, again for me, there are multiple demands which are formed. One is red, blue, green. Okay. For me, this was a demand. It just touched this level and again formed a new demand, which is, let's say, green to blue and then green. So now again for me, there's a demand on a weekly chart. So you can still consider investing this stock at around 33, 34 levels as well. Again, same concept. In case if you are getting a dip, you are supposed to go long. Again, at 33, instead of waiting for 30 level, you can still buy it at around 33 because the demand is very strong. So we are not sure that whether we are going to get the entry till 30. So you can still at least try to add it somewhere around 33. So here, that was the first resistance, and now this time it broke on the upside. Let us check volume as well. So yes, so here there was this volume, it came on to the downside and then again breakout on the upside with a huge volume. So this is the strong level for me, let's say somewhere around 33. Okay, you can still go long at around 33, but to be on a safer side, you can keep a stop loss of somewhere around 27 instead of 29. This is a weekly, but I'm checking on a higher time frame, so I'm giving more importance to monthly chart. Weekly chart is a bit strong compared to monthly because monthly candle is not yet formed. So these are two wide range candle coming with a huge volume. The volume is somewhere around 287 million. So ideally this is considered a very good volume, right? There was this consolidation and the volumes were dropping, and then now there's a upside, breakout of the upside with a huge volume, again forming a demand zone. So for me, this is a must buy stop. Now again, the same concept that I'm going to check on a left side whether we have any supply zone. This is not a supply zone, and again it has already broken, so I'm not going to give much major importance. Okay, now if you see this level, like green, blue, red, and this is blue, so obviously this is also not a supply zone. Again, no importance here. Left, no. And now here if you see at somewhere around 108, again that is my Fibonacci target. But here if you see, the first time when this stock had crashed from this level, or I would say started falling down from this level. There was this green, there was this blue, and there was this red. So this is a fresh demand, so supply zone, which is not yet tested. Let's say somewhere around 117, okay? And again, apart from that, I do not have any supply zone, okay? So for me, if I go and try to draw this, okay, horizontal line is already drawn. Right, so now if you see, what I'm expecting from this talk is, again, I'll be going on a monthly time frame. Yes. Buy at CMP, which is 41. Buy at CMP, which is 41. And add on dip still 33. Stop loss is 27, and target which I'm expecting is, first target for me is obviously 107, and in case if you want to extend that target, then it should be 117, I think. Let me, because I'm not going to ignore 117, but what I'm expecting is, in case whenever you get this target, which is 107, which I'm expecting, book 80% and rest 117 should be kept as for the final target. It can even do a double top, but then again, since this is on a monthly chart, so I'm not going to predict exactly how it is going to react which way. But my only point is, right now there's a very good opportunity to go long in this stock, okay, from an investment perspective. You can buy it at current market price. Again, going on to the monthly chart. Yes. So you can buy it at a current market price, which is 41. And where is my text? Yes, this one. Or let me consider it as a weekly chart. Yes, like this. Sorry for that. Yes. So again, just a recap. If you see on a weekly chart, the demand zone is already formed. If you see on a monthly chart, it is still forming a demand zone. It has already reacted once from this weekly demand, or let's say monthly demand. But right now, if you see, there is a fresh demand with a huge volume. It can give you a pullback, but then you should consider it as a buying opportunity. If you buy it at around 41, even if you buy at around 41, and if I'm expecting, let's say, 107 as my first target, so I'm expecting at least, I think, 150%. If you consider the risk reward, it is highly favorable. So from an investment perspective, you can go long in this stock. So that's it from my end. I do not see any major reason that it should fall below this level, because the price action is on a good side, and I'm expecting this stock to be a kind of multi-bagger. At least, even if you're getting more than 100%, it should be considered as a multi-bagger. So that's it, friends, from my end. Do let me know if you are willing to invest in this stock. Thank you so much.